Good evening. We begin keeping them honest on a busy and consequential night with a tweet from the president and a passage from the Constitution. First, the tweet, and note the fact that this is from Donald Trump back in 2014. And I'm quoting, "Repubs must not allow Prez Obama to subvert the Constitution of the U.S. for his own benefit and because he is unable to negotiate with Congress." And now, from the Constitution, Article 1, Section 9. It reads, "No money shall be drawn from the Treasury but in consequence of appropriations made by law." Now, whichever you consider more important, the framers' words from 1787 or Donald Trump's from 2014, the president today turned his back on both. And whether you want to call it his inability to fulfill a campaign promise that Mexico would pay for the wall or to negotiate with Congress or merely dissatisfaction with the outcome, he's just made his own political difficulties over the border and the budget into a national emergency. He's chosen a course that CNN polling shows two-thirds of the country is against and that senior members of his own party begged him not to take before ultimately giving in to him. He's starting down a path that could lead to a showdown with Democrats and some Republicans in Congress and a fight in the courts over what those words in the Constitution really mean, all over his decision to inflate what is certainly a serious and chronic problem into an acute crisis that only immediate emergency action can address. Now, for perspective, there are 31 active items right now under the National Emergencies Act, some dating back to the Carter administration. There's sanctions during the Iran hostage ordeal, sanctions during the Balkan conflict. There's a whole range of measures immediately after the 9/11 attacks, as well as other responses to a string of lesser international conflicts over the years. The question will be, does what's happening on the border qualify? And if it does, why didn't he declare an emergency instead of shutting down the government and making 800,000 Americans go without pay? Why not last December or the year before? Why not the moment he took office? After all, the number of arrests on the border, while fluctuating somewhat, was roughly the same then as it is now. What makes it a crisis today, but not 2 years ago? Now, you can argue the president is only doing what he promised his voters he'd do. You can say he's been calling for a wall for years. But keeping him honest, even what seems to be a bedrock belief for him, even that may not be all it seems. Here's a passage in Josh Green's book on the rise of Trump and Steve Bannon, quoting former campaign official Sam Nunberg on the origins of the wall, the whole idea of the wall. And I'm reading from the book, quote, "Roger Stone and I came up with the idea of the wall, and we talked to Steve Bannon about it," according to Nunberg. "It was to make sure he," meaning Donald Trump, "talked about immigration," meaning he talked about it during speeches, that he would remember to talk about immigration, so they came up with the idea of the wall. Nothing more than a memory aid, according to him. Now it's a national emergency, or will be tomorrow when the president signs the budget bill that's making its way through Congress tonight, right now. CNN's Jim Acosta joins us from the White House. What are you hearing from your sources tonight, Jim, on all this?
Anderson, this is shaping up to be a campaign promise emergency for the president, and I think we're going to see some of this play out tomorrow. I talked to a White House official earlier this evening who said that the plan is now set for the president to either declare a national emergency tomorrow or announce some sort of executive action that he's taking that would essentially try to redirect funds that have already been appropriated to the executive branch, to the Trump administration, to fund this wall down on the border. And the question is whether or not, obviously, whether he can legally do that. According to this White House official, just about every lawyer in the administration has reviewed this, and they are anticipating legal challenges. The House Speaker Nancy Pelosi said earlier today that she's looking at this. The Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer has also said this. And there have been a number of Republican senators up on Capitol Hill who have warned the White House that this could get tied up in courts for some time. And so, Anderson, the president is running out of cards. Originally, he said Mexico was going to pay for it. Then it was the trade deal. And then he shut down the government to force Congress to pay for it. And now he's essentially down to his last option, which is to try to take some kind of executive action to make this happen.
Do we know, is there going to be any kind of ceremony tomorrow when the president signs the bill, declares the national emergency, if that's in fact what he does?
I think the details in terms of how they're going to announce it is still being worked out. We do think that he is going to sign. We do know he's going to sign the bill because Mitch McConnell said that earlier today. Whether he signs that bill in front of everybody remains to be seen. But we do expect to have some kind of announcement tomorrow, whether it's in front of the cameras or just via paper. But I suspect it'll be in front of the cameras where the president is going to set out what he's planning to do. That is according to the current planning at this point. But Anderson, as soon as he does that, and if he does declare a national emergency, this is almost a sure thing that this is headed towards the courts. And then it becomes sort of an academic discussion as to whether or not there's enough time between now and the 2020 election for the president to fulfill this campaign promise, because he may be facing months, if not years, of legal challenges as to whether or not, as you were just pointing out a few moments ago, whether or not he could go around the Constitution, go around the Congress and do this. It's something that Republicans went after Barack Obama for trying to do back in 2014 when he tried to do an executive action on immigration. And now the president is essentially doing the same thing. And some of those Republican critics are now on his side.
Jim Acosta, appreciate it. Thank you. Democratic Congressman Adam Schiff chairs the House Intelligence Committee. He's got some thoughts on this. He joins us now. Chairman Schiff, you say the president's emergency declaration is plainly unconstitutional. What about it rises to that level, in your opinion?
Well, it's hard to imagine a worse case for a national emergency than a problem that has been diminishing over the years, that the intelligence heads didn't even recognize when they're outlining the threats to the country. And most significantly, that the Congress has deliberated about, reached a resolution on in terms of what the Congress believes is appropriate border security. And the president didn't get what he wanted from the Congress. And has decided that's some kind of emergency. If it was an emergency every time a president of the United States couldn't get what they wanted from Congress, we would be in a constant state of emergency. So it's the worst possible case, and it will fail. But I have to say this, what has had our democracy on such shaky ground for the last 2 years has not just been the unconstitutional acts of the president, but the fact that Congress has not been willing to stand up to him, that in particular the president's party has not been willing to stand up to him, and the fact that Mitch McConnell would warn him privately but then do a complete 180 and publicly embrace this shows you just the kind of capitulation that is endangering the rule of law and our system of checks and balances.
Yeah, I mean, you've called on your Republican colleagues to oppose the move. We've already heard some of them expressing their reservations about it, but do you expect actually any condemnation to go beyond simply, you know, some statements of disapproval?
Well, look, if passes prologue, we can't expect very much. There is a complete, and I think it's a groupthink, lack of political courage in the GOP right now. There's not a single member, I think, of either body that thinks this is a good idea, except maybe politically, and even then, I think they think it's a poor idea. But they lack the courage of their convictions. I'm not particularly interested in private reservations or even public murmurings. We do need them to vote their oath to the Constitution. And again, there's not a lot of reason for optimism, but they will be put to the test. There should be a resolution of disapproval, and they will be forced to go on the record of whether they're going to defend the Constitution or they're going to merely do the president's will.
Speaker Pelosi today said the Democrats are reviewing their options to challenge it. How should that happen, do you think? I mean, in the courts, legislatively, both?
Well, it'll certainly be challenged in the courts, and it'll be stopped in the courts. You know, I think that it is likely, although I'm speaking just for myself and not as a representative of the leadership, that we will have an opportunity to vote and disapprove of what the president is doing. You know, while that may pass in the House, I would hope would pass in the House, the Senate will be a closer call. But I do think people should be put on record. And for all of those members that have criticized presidents in the past for overreach, none of them have done anything like what this president is attempting to do. That ought to not only worry them, but it ought to prompt them to action.
Do you think the president actually cares whether or not it passes in the courts? As long as he is seen as having attempted it, he can then say in 2020, look, I tried my best. It's the Democrats. All these people just took us to court and, you know, they killed us in the courts, but I tried.
I don't think he cares at all whether this passes constitutional muster. He certainly doesn't care whether it's constitutional, but he also doesn't care what happens when it gets challenged in the courts. All he really wants to do is present some fig leaf. He's getting less funding today than he would have if he hadn't shut down the government. He's getting criticized by the same conservatives that caused him to shut down the government to begin with. So this is a political maneuver. And really not more than that in terms of the president. But in terms of the Congress, we ought to care much more about it than that, because the precedent that it sets is just terrible.
Yeah, as you mentioned, I mean, Mitch McConnell had advised reportedly the president not to declare the national emergency. Then today we saw him take to the Senate floor, endorse this move. Are you clear at all how he got from point A to point B?
Well, the same way he has so many times in the past, and that is, you know, the obligation to our institutions is very secondary. What is primary for him is keeping control of the majority in the Senate, and if that means that he's going to go along with the president on a plainly unconstitutional act, apparently he is willing to do that. I think that's a terrible disservice, but look, you know, for someone who kept the Supreme Court seat vacant for over a year with the same object of energizing his base, keeping his position as majority leader, it can't be all that surprising.
Congressman Schiff, appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you.